So for this lecture, we're going to talk about cellular reproduction, specifically mitosis and meiosis. And we want to start with looking at the overall cell cycle. The cell cycle is just the life cycle of the cell. So we're going to think about right here. This is where a cell is born and begins its life, and it's going to go all the way around through its life cycle. So just like an organism is born, grows, and dies, cells are going to go through the same process. And if we look at the cell cycle, there are two main parts. There's interphase, which includes G1, S phase, and G2. And then we have mitosis and cytokinesis, and that's going to be this portion of the life cycle. So notice interphase is 75% of the life cycle, and mitosis is the last 25%. And this is just an approximate representation. So what happens during interphase? There's three parts, G1, S, and G2. The cell is going to do its job. So if you have a stomach cell, it's going to produce stomach acid. If you've got a pancreas cell, you're going to make insulin. Whatever it is that cell does, it's going to do throughout interphase. And hopefully it makes sense that this is the most important thing a cell can do. This lecture is going to focus a lot on mitosis and this last bit of the cell cycle. But remember that interphase is the most important time when the cell is actually doing its job. During G1 and G2 phases, the cell is also going to go through growth. And that's where we get the letter G, growth 1 and growth 2. So during S phase, the cell is going to copy or replicate its DNA. It's called S phase because of DNA synthesis. So this is when we're synthesizing additional DNA. As I mentioned, interphase is going to take up most of the life cycle of the cell, and that's because it's doing its job, and that's what we need your cells to be doing most of the time. Then if we look at mitosis, mitosis is when we split up copied DNA between two new cells. And mitosis has four phases or steps: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. And we'll learn more about the details of those in a little bit. Cytokinesis is when a single cell physically splits into two cells. Mitosis is going to split up the DNA. Cytokinesis is going to split one cell into two. And once you finish cytokinesis, you have finished the life cycle of a single cell. So why do cells reproduce? They get old, they get damaged, or if the organism needs to grow, we need to add new cells. So these are all different reasons why cells might reproduce. So not all cells are going to reproduce at the same rate. Skin cells are going to replace themselves every 2 weeks. We actually rely on a layer of dead skin cells on the outside of our skin as part of our immune response so that we can protect the internal tissues. But those cells slough off and we need to replace them every 2 weeks. Red blood cells, they're going to live 80 to 120 days or so and will be produced in the bone marrow every 4 months. Stomach lining cells are going to replace themselves every 2 days. It's a highly acidic environment. Individual cells just can't survive there very long, and so they're constantly being replaced. As an adult, you will never have new nerve cells grow. Now, individual nerve cells can grow longer processes. They have these long parts called dendrites, but they're not going to go through the normal process of mitosis. So if you lose nerve cells, you don't reproduce those. You don't get them back after they're damaged. Cells that don't reproduce go into what's called a G0 phase, and they never complete the life cycle of the cell. They don't go through S phase, G2, or mitosis.